Ta'Quan, you're back, man. You look pretty good out there. Yes, how's your knee feeling?
Feeling great. Really good to be back out here with the guys.
Take us through scrimmage today. How'd you feel out there? How did things go?
Confident. You know, anytime I get to go out there, play the game that I love, it's always going to be fun. Having those five guys in front of me, you know, just always got a positive attitude going out there.
Ta'Quan, was the rehab from an ACL the hardest thing you've ever done?
For sure.
In what ways?
Obviously physically, but also mentally. I think it brought a different guy out of me that I never thought I had. But yeah, it's severe. I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy.
How do you feel now physically?
I'm feeling really good.
What did it feel like? What went through your mind the first time you got on that field and you felt like, yeah, I'm back, I'm all the way back? Have you had that kind of breakthrough moment yet?
Of course, first day out, you know, just being out there, I think it was the first team period. Just being out there behind the line, and I think I completed the pass. So I mean, just smile, you know, just haven't done it in almost a year. So yeah. It was just fun to be out there and not watch it from the side.
And you see it brought out a different person.
Yeah.
Can you expand on that a little bit?
I feel like when you have major surgery, you know, it's really intense, the rehab process. I was out for about 10 to 11 months. So, you know, just waking up and doing the same rehab every day, you know, some people, they wouldn't be able to take it, you know what I mean? It was just, you know, I just trusted God and trusted the process, trusted our trainers, and the guy supported me, and I got through it.
You know, when you transferred here, obviously, if you wanted to play, you were going to be the starter, you lead the team down the field the first series of the year, and then, of course, you get hurt. How long did it take you to kind of go through the stages of, you know, maybe being angry, maybe being sad, maybe doubting whether you'd ever play again? I mean, what was those first week or two after that injury?
First week or two, it was just really bad. It was really bad. But like I said before, you know, just having the guys in the locker room, it made me feel much better, you know, being able to. I really couldn't, you know, mourn because I had a young guy in my room, Zion. I had to help him out. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, I'm a UConn Husky, and, you know, team first before myself, even when I'm hurt. So I kind of had to flip the switch fast and, you know, prepare for a role at CCSU and just, you know, to win that game.
So that was the thing that kind of got your mind off?
Of course. If it wasn't for this team, I don't know. It wouldn't be so well.
This is a competition, but you're all pulling for each other, obviously, but yes, you want this job, right?
I mean, of course, but at the end of the day, the best man will win. Trust Coach Charlton and Coach Moore and whoever goes into this decision, but you know, with all of us, so of course.
With the competition, how important is it for you guys to be good teammates for each other?
Oh, it's huge. It's huge. I've mentioned it before. I know the other guys mentioned it before. Our QB room is really tight, and we get each other better. And I just feel like we're just a tight knit group. So it's just huge.
What's the depth like? It seems like there's a lot of player makers at every position. Do you feel like this team has real enough depth?
Of course. I feel like we have a lot of playmakers. I feel like we got depth at each position. And as I mentioned before, playing behind those five guys on the O-line, I feel like every game we go into, we got a shot.
I feel like Coach Moore has really raised the bar, obviously, with what you guys accomplished last year. And feels like there's different expectations this year. Is that something that you also try to put on to the team as a leader in the quarterback position? Or how do you kind of take on that role of the higher expectations?
We're a football team at the end of the day. All we want to do is win. And, you know, when 100 and something guys have that goal in the locker room to win, like everyone say, like the standard is the standard, you know. We just want to get 1% better and want to know each week.
In all the years that you've been kind of chasing this since you left high school, what's kept you going? What's kept you at it, kept you fighting through the adversity that you've faced?
Honestly, first and foremost, I'd like to thank God, my family, my immediate family, and obviously the locker room I've been in.
How close do you feel you are to kind of grasping that dream? Does it feel within reach now?
Of course. Hey, like I said before, I don't like to think too far ahead, considering what happened last year. But I'm just focused on, you know, just watching this tape from this practice and just getting better every day.